Hi friends, today's Joy of Reading story is Why Don't Birds Comb Their Hair? The author is Suchi Govindarajan, illustrator is Anyora Noronha, the publisher is Pratham Books. So, it is a story about why birds do not comb their hair like us. Let's see. Why don't bulbuls comb their hair? It looks like a little wave. If I had a bulbul's hair, I would wear clips. So here is the red whiskered bulbul. And look at its hair. It's like in waves. And this boy is saying, if he had a bulbul's hair, he would wear clips. Why don't hoopoes comb their hair? It looks like a frilly fan. If I had a hoopoe's hair, I would push it back with a band. So, this is the common hoopoe. It is a bird that is found in Africa, Asia, Europe, everywhere. And look at its hair. It looks like a fan and it's frilly because it means it has different pleats, like one after the other, you can see one on top of the other, all these individual things. If this boy says, if he had like a hoopoe's hair, he would put a band around it. Why don't spoonbills comb their hair? It looks like an old paintbrush. If I had a spoonbill's hair, I would plait it all together. So this is a spoonbill. And why is it called so? Look at its bill or its beak. It's like a big flat spoon. That's why it's called a spoonbill. And look at its hair. It looks like a paintbrush. You've seen brush that we use to paint, right? Paint colors or a picture. So it looks like those bristles. And what does this boy say? If he had a spoonbill's hair, he would all plait it up or put a braid. Why don't monals comb their hair? It looks like a tiny broom. If I had a monal's hair, I would tie it up with ribbons. So this is the monal, which is found in Himalayas. And it's a very, very, very beautiful bird, looking very colorful. And look at its hair. It looks like a tiny broom, the broom that we use to sweep our houses, right? Like one bristle, it looks like a tiny broom. And the boy says, if he had a monal's hair, he would tie it up a ribbon in his hair, like this red color ribbon that you can see here. Why don't fish owls comb their hair? It looks like two furry worms. If I had a fish owl's hair, I would make two ponytails. So this is a fish owl. And look at its two furry worms here. Its hair is like that. And this boy says, if he had hair like that, he would put a ponytail, put a band, rubber band there and put a ponytail like this. Why don't drongos comb their hair? It looks like a messy mop. If I had a drongo's hair, I would oil it well and brush it down. So this is a drongo. Look at its long racket tail. It's called a racket tail drongo. Look at its long tail. And look at its head. How does its hair look? It's all untidy here and there, right? Like a messy mop. So untidy hair with like going here and there. And what this boy says, if he had hair like drongo, he would nicely apply oil on his head and comb it and brush it all down so that it is neat. Why don't hornbills have hair to comb? They look like they are wearing helmets. If I had a hornbill's helmet, I would ride around all day. So look at the hornbill. And it doesn't seem to have hair, but it's like a helmet that is there on top. The boy says, if he had a helmet like that, he would keep riding the scooter all throughout the day. Why don't vultures have any hair? They look so bald. If I had a vulture's head, I would never have to comb my hair. So this is a vulture. It feeds on dead things. And this is an Indian vulture. It has no hair on its head. And the boy says, it will be if he is bald or having no hair like the vulture, then he need not comb his hair at all. Meet the birds that have funny hair. So let's see all these birds that have this funny type of hair. Himalayan monal, and we saw, right, the pretty, pretty bird. Common hoopoe. The hoopoe is found in Africa, Asia, Europe. It's pretty common. Indian vulture. So this is the vulture which has no hair on its head. And the Eurasian spoonbill. The spoonbill that is in Europe and Asia. Red whiskered bulbul. So this is the bulbul. You can see this red spot here, right? They are like whiskers. The cat, you see some hairs, right, on its near its nose. They are called whiskers. Similarly, the red bulbul has also red colored whiskers out here. The great Indian hornbill. So look at the great Indian hornbill. It is found in Kerala. And in fact, it is a state bird of Kerala. There are lots of this great Indian hornbill found there. The brown fish owl. Look at it, the brown fish owl, which has two ear tufts out here. It is called a fish owl because you can see, you know, its front part looks like scales in a fish. If you see a fish, you can see something similar pattern in a fish as well out here. And this is the racket-tailed drongo. Look at its tail. It's like a racket or a bat. Do birds really have hair? Some birds look like they have hair on their heads, but their hair is not like ours. Instead, each hair is just a very thin feather. A group of such feathers is called a crest. Crests are useful in many ways. They make birds look attractive. Some birds can open and fold their crests to send signals to other birds. Some open their crests when they want to frighten away other birds and animals. So it seems that birds have hair on their heads like us. But is it like ours? Not exactly. So each hair is nothing but a feather. You can see here, right? It is just a feather. And a group of all these feathers that you can see in this hoopoe, the group of feathers is called a crest. So this crest that the birds have is useful to the bird in many ways. So first of all, they make the birds look very attractive or very beautiful so that you're keeping looking at this bird because it's so beautiful. And some birds, what they do, they open and fold. They open and they fold their crest to give signals or information to another bird. It's a way of communication. And some of them open their crests as well to frighten other birds and animals. The furry worms on the owl's head are called ear tufts. They are not really ears, just bits of skin covered with feathers. These help owls hide more easily, making them look like they are part of a tree. The ear tufts also help them look attractive to other owls or scary to other birds and animals. So this is the owl, and we talked about those two furry worms on the side of the owl, right? They are called as ear tufts, and they're not really ears like us, but they're just bits of skin covered with these feathers. So how does it help the owl? So that when they hide behind the tree or something, they look as though they're part of the tree, and this helps them to hide away from other animals that can come to attack them. And these ear tufts also make them look attractive or nice to other owls. But if it's another bird or an animal, it can look scary as well, so that they are not attacked by other birds and animals. The hornbill's helmet is called a casque. It rhymes with mask. So just as you say mask, you say cask. Like ear tufts and crests, casks make hornbills look good. This helps them find mates. A hornbill's cask also makes its beak stronger. With a strong beak, hornbills can pick and eat fruits more easily. So this is the hornbill. And what is it called on its head? That is called the helmet, is called a cask. And just like ear tufts and crests, this cask makes the hornbill look good. And hence, they can find a partner that helps them. It makes them look nice and it helps them to find a partner or mates. Now, this cask also has another benefit. It makes its beak stronger so that they can eat on hard nuts and fruits very easily as well. So with that, I hope you enjoyed this story along with me, knowing about how these different birds have hair on their head. Thank you. Let us see some of the difficult words in the story. Tuft, a bunch or collection of hairs or threads or grass. So in this story, it is feathers, a collection of feathers. Crest, group or tuft of feathers on top of a bird's head. Cask, helmet. Scary, frightening or causing fear. Attractive, pleasing or appealing to look at. Try some of these questions. You may discuss it with your friends. Write in your own words what crest means and list all the birds that have crest in this story. Take one bird from the story and write details about it. You may search the internet. Name some of the birds that you have seen that have either a crest or a cask or ear tufts. Thank you.